You came out?
Oh, yeah, the store I went into.
Wait, what? Congrats, bro.
No, I was leaving, and then... Oh, I didn't see you there. Hi. Welcome back to the groove.
Welcome back to the Groot
podcast. I'm Dr. Nuh-uh. This is my associate. Nurse Nuh-uh.
Hello. Nuh-uh.
Ask me a question.
What code do you use to get 10% off?
A yes or no question.
Oh, are you 30?
Nuh-uh.
Oh. Wait, I'm Nuh-uh.
You got me.
Wait, aren't I Nuh-uh?
I'm Dr. Nuh-uh. You're nurse.
Nuh-uh. Yeah, so why did you say Nuh-uh?
I said Nuh-uh.
One more time. Run that back. Are you having fun sitting on the podcast right now?
Yeah.
Are you 5'10"?
Nuh-uh.
Oh.
Wow.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Group Chat Podcast, episode
119. 119?
Make sure you use code GROOVE.
For what?
10
per
dollars.
Said.
For what?
$10.
On
ten.
What? Where?
10% How? Off.
Where do I do?
On your GamerSubs.
Where do I go?
Purchase.
How do I use it?
Go to gamersubs.gg/.
Wow.
GamerSubs. Oh, wait. /group.
Does that work?
Yeah, that works. Gamersubs.gg/group.
And buy $1 million worth of stuff.
$1 million.
$1 million worth of stuff for me, please?
Is there $1 million worth of stuff in the website?
I think so. I think GamerSubs makes like $1 million a year. So anyway, let's address the pickle in the room. Can we address the pickle in the room? There's no Larry.
Like, where the hell?
Like, where'd he even go? Maybe.
Imagine I had only boxer briefs on right now.
Larry, if you're here speaking I heard him somewhere. Wait, Larry, real quick, what happened to the
say
podcast?
The
Where's the podcast?
Where's the podcast?
I think there's an affirmation in the room, bro. Are you hearing this?
I hear him saying, like, oh no, we're getting mold on the ceiling. Listeners at home, we have brown mold on the ceiling. In the shapes of poops, emoji poops.
Yeah, you guys heard
camera
about
camera two. Can we get a zoom on that?
Camera two, can we zoom in? Yeah, we have a really, really, we have a lot to go over today, starting with the monkeypox horrible thing. And now look at this. The monkey mold is now a thing. Look it, it's already here. In
our house. I think that if we opened up that lean tub right there, monkeypox would be in there.
I think that is monkeypox.
Mm-hmm.
That's monkeypox.
We can get that and take a little vial and put it into fruits. And hey, ever remember that story?
What?
People were taking HIV and AIDS and injecting them into oranges and then selling them to try and get people.
How do I know I can trust you?
It was a story. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe this is just a misinformation podcast. Hey, Larry, where's that podcast episode?
Yeah, okay, where is that podcast episode? All right, let's trail back to, first of all, what happened after we stopped doing the podcast, like mm-hmm. recording the episode.
Okay, so we recorded the episode, and then you press stop on our recording device, and then it didn't stop recording.
Right there.
That thing did not stop recording. So as a result, what are you doing? Didn't stop recording, and then Larry was like, "All right, fudge it. I'm just gonna pull out the SD card." Pulls out the SD card, and none of it saved. Wait, no, it's
saved.
It's saved. It was just that the cameras had like really crappy quality because the f-stops on them were too high or some shit, too low.
Yeah, it was really high, so it got really, really dark.
Right.
It got really dark.
Yeah, so that was kind of an L moment. And
yeah.
And then we thought of like, oh, hey, what if we did like some fun 3D stuff?
Yeah.
And then that took way too long because we're amateurs here.
Yeah,
you know,
amateur
we're not,
hour.
Yeah, so then Larry decided to do what anyone normally would do is give up and go to bed.
Dude, why would you say we the whole time and then Larry gives up? You're like, so we made a bunch of 3D stuff and then Larry just threw in the towel. So
well, I think because
I did throw in the towel because he called me and I was waking up. I was like, Nick, I think I give up on this. Mm-hmm. I can't finish this in time. And people are already hating on me.
Yeah, I think it's because I said we, because I gave him the idea to do like a 3D, not 3D,
no,
like
it was a
two,
pixel.
Pixelated,
it was
like, a, yeah. like us just like kind of sitting around in a circle or something like that, dancing. Or I think we need to address the other elephant in the room here. The only person that we heard from back for the podcast today was Grunk. Grunk is not here because Grunk is now a parent.
Yeah,
let's just
isn't that crazy.
Yeah, we have a new recording time, so you know, Can't really blame everyone for not really being here. But Grunk called up last second. He said, hey, I actually can't make that because I am now a parent to Tallulah and Davey.
He's got twins.
Oh, you know, Harvey. Sorry, oh, Harvey. Not Davey. Oh. Tallulah and Harvey.
Tallulah and Harvey are cats.
Yeah. Well, alleged cats.
Allegedly.
We do have a framed photo of them.
Where?
Right here. Oh.
That's you, bro.
No.
But anyway, they look happy. They're black and white, by the way.
Are they? I didn't see them.
Mm-hmm.
I came upstairs and he was on the phone with Grunk.
I didn't see him either.
Sorry, guys.
I didn't see him either.
Then why are you lying?
He told me.
Oh.
So maybe, like, if anything, that's how, like, I feel like that's how misinformation spreads, man, you know? Like,
it's a game of telephone.
I could say, dude, game is a telephone. They suck, man. They're bad.
I hate telephone. I like Monopoly.
Monopoly Go?
No, just Monopoly.
I love Monopoly Go. If you go to the link in the description, you can download Monopoly Go for free using my code.
What's the code? Come on, guys. At the same time. 3, 2, 1.
Group.
Willie.
So we were talking about Propel earlier, and the fact that, can you bring it up for a second? We need to show them something. Something really interesting about this. Hey, since when the fuck was Propel owned by Gatorade? Can we, like, find out real fast? Because I remember Propel was not owned by Gatorade. Look at this guy.
Yeah, you just take the laptop, dude.
Yeah, I don't know why you're doing that.
It's all yours.
He wrote Gatorade Propel acquired. How did you properly spell acquisition, but you fucked up Propel and Gatorade? Look at the Google search. It's correcting Gatorade and Propel, but acquisition's perfect. Did you mean Gatorade Propel?
Yeah, I did. Who currently owns PepsiCo after the acquisition of Quaker Oats? Quaker Oats got bought?
Yeah. Fuck the big three. It's just me, big me.
Fuck the big three. It's me.
It's like Mario.
Why are you
the big three? It's me.
You're like, fuck the big three. It's just big me. No, what'd you say?
No, you fucked it up.
Well, because
I can't even fuck it up that bad.
You said it right.
I said it right.
You said it right, but it's because there's like...
It's just me.
There's a word in there I can't say, and it fucked me up. Yeah, that.
The big three. It's just me.
You think if we had like a censor button that we all physically can press, and it made like a beep, it would get like abused in this podcast?
Yeah.
Yeah. I would just play with it.
I wouldn't even touch it.
Oh, bullshit. You wouldn't touch it.
I would touch it, but only when I don't want to. Like, when it's not called for. I'll be like, beep.
How beep you? And you have to say, how are you? Right? Like that is an example?
Mm-hmm.
Use another example.
What the fuck? Beep. Oh, damn it. And that's what I'm going to do.
Oh.
Like, I'm
going to miss it up. Oh, I get it. He's using it at the wrong time.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to forget about it.
No, that was
I'm
good. That's good.
It.
Yeah, that's good. Who is that? Since when was that there?
Who is that? Who is that?
Who is this?
It's a bib. I think it's Biggie.
I don't want to say. I don't know who it is.
I bought him.
You bought him and you don't know who he is?
Yeah.
Do you know who it is?
No. You know what that title
Biggie.
Is?
Oh, it's Biggie. What?
The title on... the title on there is like... Small garden gnome. Small man rapper gnome for your garden.
Oh, you're saying they describe it like...
Yeah.
They use descriptions instead.
They never say the name.
Yeah, that's real.
Like the Snoop Dogg was called like weed friend.
High guy.
Yeah, high weed guy from...
Chill, super lax guy.
Mm-hmm.
Hot dog.
Smoke marijuana guy.
What if they use like keywords like Snoopy guy eating a hot dog?
How does
Snoop Dogg, but keywords, you know what I'm saying? Can I talk about something kind of crazy right now? It's a current event. Remember when I was talking to you guys about the world of t-shirts?
Yeah.
Okay. Joshua Block, some shit's going the fuck down, okay? So I'm going to New York. Like, I'm actually going back home to visit Misty, back to New Jersey.
Uh-huh.
And, that's just not only why, but, you know, I got to go hang out with the girl, you know? She's over there. She's blind now. I got to go see her.
Full?
Pretty much, yeah. That's what diabetes does, I think, the insulin that you give her. But anyway, I'm going to go to New York, and I booked a tour with Joshua Block, the World of T-Shirts guy. I booked a tour with him because I feel like there's a lot of shit going down right now. Honestly, but all the shit that's going down, I think I just wasted $60 because I don't think I'm going to get a tour. I'm going to New York to get a tour at 9 o'clock at night.
You paid $60 bucks?
Yeah, for me and Grant.
You're not getting nothing, bro. So it's not happening.
So we're gonna walk around. I'm pretty sure I just paid for just alcohol, essentially.
$60 is long the Long Island iced tea day time.
Yeah, we're going to just have a whole bunch of twisted teas, I think. But look, the point is that there's a lot of stuff going on right now where he's pretty much getting exploited by a guy named Mr. Bass. And there's a lot of issues. Like, Mr. Bass just assaulted. My mom's calling me. this kid's getting exploited by a guy named Mr. Bass. And Mr. Bass just assaulted somebody in New York. And now he's, like, lawyering up or something like that. He, like, cut, like, a big gash in his head and shit like that.
Of course it's a fucking kick streamer, dude.
Yeah, I'm telling you, it's really bad. And so my plan is to go to New York.
Oh my god.
I want to see Joshua Block if I possibly can. And bro, so this kid has autism and he's an alcoholic, and I feel the kind of need and inclination as a creator that's not going to exploit this guy to just go there. And the only reason why I booked a tour was to be able to like get to talk to him, you know what I'm saying? And just kind of like see if there's any way I can help him.
We have to talk about the future. We have to predict.
Let's talk about the fact that the Costco guys or the Costco boys are like crushing it right now. Boom! 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 You know what I'm talking about? Come on, you know what I'm talking about.
That was awesome. I like that.
They're from New Jersey. You don't follow them?
I feel like you probably crossed paths with them at least once.
You've probably
met them somewhere.
I have at least one friend that looks like the little like kid. From when he was younger.
Sure. Dude, if we just fill in your eyebrows, you are one of them.
His eyes are just like so big and so green and bright for no reason.
Can you look him up, Isaac, real quick?
Oh, boy.
Just pull up the laptop to yourself.
Dude,
man.
It's Cord, bro.
Dude, pull Cord, the Cord.
Bro. What's his name? The Costco guys?
Huh? Search up the Costco. The Cosmo Kid. Look up the Cosmo Kid.
Why these guys?
I need to say something now, and it's really getting out of hand. People that post on Twitter clips of other people's content but post their watermarks over it. Fearbuck did that. He posted Meat Canyon's entire video of the Costco guys and put his watermark over it.
Oh my god.
And then dude, wanna hear something even more insufferable? Fucking putting steak, like a steak logo on a clip.
Yeah, they get paid for that.
Isaac, can you start putting your videos like random logos that don't have anything to do with the video? And just
Target, Home Depot,
Def Jam.
Has it a Walmart logo for no reason?
Toyota.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Cartier.
Oh shit.
Start branding TMZ for no reason randomly. We did that for one of the Twitter, like we did a tweet where I took a telescope in Minecraft and I was stalking Tanner and I took a screenshot and I put a TMZ logo on it and I just put it on Twitter.
That was so fun.
That was great. And then we took a photo of the voice call, put a TMZ over logo over that, and then it just kept going.
Wow. Like
one of these days, I'm going to go in Isaac's room, and I'm going to put a TMZ logo over his from his bedroom window.
You remember the live leak? Just putting a live leak over something? You know?
I had a bunch of logos on one of my streams where it had live leak, CNN, Fox. Just a bunch of news crap all over my screen. It was great. It's fun. It feels very important.
Yeah.
It makes it feel very important.
Makes it feel very official.
Yeah.
Just even having like that little red circle of a camera recording at the bottom. It's like, oh shit.
Like watch this. I'm gonna pan to you and you're gonna say something so unserious, but it's gonna look serious. We're gonna have a logo. We're gonna have it like shit on it. Ready?
Okay. I love Propel.
Mm-mm.
Oh, something less serious? Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Wait, what's less serious than I Love Propel? Go ahead, you try.
I need a bud.
Bro.
I need a bud.
We're Costco guys. Of course we... Double chunk chocolate cookie. Boom. Boom. But you got to do five booms.
Dude, they keep on doing. They did this one collab with this kid, this little kid. Mm-hmm. And he just looked so lost. like the entire time.
Not their son?
No.
Not the Rizzler?
No. Not what?
You're not seriously, bro.
What is wrong with you?
No, dude,
these guys of all people?
He knows.
Dude.
The Rizzler?
Yeah, his name's the Rizzler.
Yeah, but why do you know?
He makes the Chad face. Bro, for someone who spends so much time on TikTok and like you just be bringing up random shit. You're like, oh, I saw that video.
Yeah,
how do you not know?
I see the video. You don't go and do research on them and build lore in my head about the Costco guys.
Yo, Nick, whistle a tune.
What?
Whistle a tune.
No.
My CPA is calling me.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah. He just texted me and said it's all over. Hello, my baby. Hello, my darling. That hello, my ragtime gal.
That was it. Dude, Isaac, we were talking about this. Like, there's something I can always give Isaac credit for, which is fucking insane to say. Like, he is a literal No, I'm not saying it like that, bro. I'm saying like...
It's heaven
like,
forbid.
I can't ever give this guy credit, ever.
So I gotta say something positive about my friend. God, fucking fuck. Just the worst.
Shout out to that episode, by the way, where half of you struggled. I'm not gonna lie.
With the compliment thing?
You especially.
Yeah. Oh, I kept on pairing together Larry and Tanner.
You're like a lot like Larry. All right.
Tanner, please.
you're a lot like Larry.
Tanner... You and Larry.
And you just didn't get it. You got so pissed.
I don't know why. I think it was because I always assumed they're almost like the same person. It feels like two brains in two different bodies, but they're the same brain.
Especially back at that other house when you guys had the Jack and the Jill bathroom. You guys were one body.
I swear you were.
I was going to say that you are a real life Shazam. I don't give a fuck. Like, you blow my mind how... We could just be like, yo, Isaac, how's it going? And, like, and you're like, oh, it's, and you snap a little bit, you snap a few times, and then you go like this. He takes his phone, and he starts typing like this, like really weird like this with his pointer finger, and then he's like, is it this, bro?
Give me a song.
A song?
Yeah.
Nah, I mean... It really does depend. I think it just really depends on like what we're listening to, man.
Well, this isn't really classic. I need to do my classical music.
What?
Doesn't he say Santa Maria?
It's
Santa Maria.
I thought it was Ave Maria.
Ave. It is Ave. It is Ave Maria.
Oh, sorry, guys. Yo, real quick, Nick, if you can try to ring up. Grunk.
Try to ring up Grunk?
Yeah.
We're calling in Steve from Wisconsin.
Yo.
Hey, is this Steve from Wisconsin?
Yeah. What's up? What do you need, man?
Hey, how are you, Steve? You're on the new podcast episode sponsored by Bud Light. How are you?
I'm pretty good. How are you?
I'm doing well.
I thought he called
me. I had a quick question for you.
Sure, yeah. I'm actually very curious what this is about, because why are you calling me?
Oh, well, you filled out the Google form that stated that you wanted us to call you and talk about your two kids that you just got.
Okay, yeah, that's what that was. Okay, I remember now.
Right. Late night last night?
Right, yeah.
Kids keeping you up?
Yeah, I'm a little sleepy today. They were hollering all damn night. It was a problem.
So tell us about your kids. You seem to be a really proud father.
Oh yeah, they're happy, they're healthy. You know, they're still getting adjusted to their new environment, but
adopted
they're being
brave
or about it.
Did you give birth?
Yeah, adopted.
Nice. What are their names?
I don't think. So we got a little boy named Harvey, and then we have a little girl named Tallulah.
Tallulah, very nice name.
Yeah, Tallulah nice. And Harvey.
How old are they?
They're about like. Shoot, when was their birthday? I think they're about like a month and a half old, maybe.
Nice. That's great.
Yeah.
That's awesome to hear. What do they look like?
They both are black and white.
Tuxedo cats?
Harvey. No, or kids? No. Not tuxedo kids. Just like, they're like cows.
Oh, they're like cows. They're spotted.
Yes, they are spotted. And our little boy Harvey has long hair and he has a little mole on his face.
Ask him about his income.
Oh, that's great. That's great.
Yes,
so,
like Marilyn Monroe.
May I ask you a question?
How much you make a year?
Sure.
What do you do for a living?
Oh, I'm actually a media market manager influencer.
Oh, great. Look, hey, I walk all around TikTok and I ask people who have successful businesses if they have anything to share with the community.
Right.
How much money have you made in a single year?
I walk all over
in
TikTok.
A year? It's been a while since I even cared how much money I made. Let's see. I think my last yearly salary was like roughly 1.2 million, give or take.
That's amazing to hear. Do you have any advice for anyone that's looking to make $1.2 million a year?
Yeah, just like use people around you. Like just use them. It's okay.
Can you give an example?
Okay, so like say you have a friend who is like, it doesn't matter how much higher they are than you in the world, like in your business or whatever. Just like kind of be their friend, and I say friend in quotation marks, until you can use them to get to the person that's above them so that you can talk to them. Just kind of drop that other friend and just rinse and repeat until you're at the top.
Yeah, that's great. That's great advice. Have you ever been poor before?
Or broke? Have you ever been broke? Once.
Not broke? Never?
No.
What is one of the?
I actually liquidate my funds, so.
Very interesting. Steve from Wisconsin, everybody.
Steve,
thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Wait, what even is your podcast, Bud Light?
We're sponsored by Bud Light. This is the hat wearing. This is the hat wearing podcast.
Okay, thank you, hat wearing podcast, for having me on.
Yeah, no problem.
You might hear more from me. Just look forward to it.
Are you able to go to that Google Doc and drop a picture of the kids?
Yeah, sure, I can do that for you.
All right, perfect. I think that the audience is adoring the two, Tallulah and Harvey. Hurricane
yes,
Harvey.
Yes, and I'll give them some candy.
What?
The audience, that is, and candy being pictures of my kids.
Aww. Oh, good metaphor.
Steve from Wisconsin here, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Whew. We appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Let's get a round of applause for them all. Bye, guys.
Thank you.
Bye, buddy.
All right. Later, Steve. I mean, later, Harvey. Fudge, man. What?
Fudge, man.
All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we just got some pictures of Steve from Wisconsin.
Honolulu.
Two beautiful children. There we go.
Aw. Damn leg.
Oh, my God.
Damn leg.
He's so cute.
Oops.
What the fuck is that?
Right there. Yep. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. Steve from Wisconsin's two children. That's the mole. That's Tallulah back there, and that's Harvey. Harvey seems to have a price tag on him. Can we zoom in on that on the left side?
Yeah. What is that?
Who is there?
That's a price tag.
Where? How did he end up with these two cats? Like real shit.
Tallulah is adorable. I will not lie.
So wait, real quick. Let me get the story right. This happened right before we were about to do this podcast, and he just. It was like a spontaneous.
Yeah, so Steve had messaged and said, hey, I'm not going to be able to make it on time for when you guys want to do that segment with me. But because I pulled a very spontaneous move and decided to rent and buy two cats.
Rent.
He's going to have a great time with them. I think so. I think that cats are amazing animals, I'll be honest. Bento, love him to death. He's starting to learn the word no. So.
Is he now?
He is. He's starting to respect me a little bit. I'm really happy about that.
That's a big one for
a cat. Yeah, yeah.
For parenthood.
Mm-hmm.
Hearing no is important.
Yeah, I think that he went through a phase of either just not knowing it or probably knew no and just kept on doing his own thing anyway. But now I say no and I point at him. I say no, and he listens. So I think that we we're on mutual playing ground there. You know, very respectful.
How's with the computer? Turning off situation.
Yeah, no, it hasn't happened in a while because I tell him before he can jump up there, I say no. I say no, Bento, come here. And then I take like a wire and I'll play with a wire and he'll come over and he respects it. I divert his attention.
I feel bad for him.
Why?
It's like every cat toy is already like, holy crap, like if I was a cat, I'd love that. But he's like cross-eyed.
But he can keep up.
But you know what happens when you cross your eyes? Do it.
Whoa. You're over there and there.
See? How many of Larry do you see?
I see two of Larry.
So can you imagine what would happen if he's like within a crowd of people? There's going to be like 40 people in front of him.
So believe it or not, they adjust.
They adjust.
They adjust.
Does that make sense?
Date just. Right here on your wrist. Where's your date just? You got a date? What's today's date? The 20th. Too slow.
Damn. Smooth, motherfucker.
Thanks, camera guy. I think this is one of our chillest and most calmest podcasts.
There's two people on set. No shit.
I think it's great. You know? I think that I think that calmer vibes sometimes need to be a thing, sometimes, maybe.
Why?
You know, in a world full of dopamine rushes, you need a dopamine detox. And we can provide that once in a while. Because we are not the type of people.
Once every 120 episodes.
Yeah.
Perhaps.
Mm-hmm. Wait, what episode are we on?
120.
Oh, we're all wrong. Well, I said 119. You said 120. Well,
think about this. We only uploaded 118. So we probably have more. We're missing.
On 125, 126.
Wait, are we on 118?
Yeah, we're on 118. Right? This is
118. Throwback to that one podcast episode when we all didn't even live together yet. And we had to keep on restarting the podcast because we kept laughing at the very beginning fucking hard.
I have that clip.
I have that clip too.
Yeah,
I do.
You have it too.
I was the one that was recording all of them. And
that was
so
episode
annoyed.
6, believe it or not, that happened.
I
liked it, but then...
No.
But then it was like, dude, we get like 30 minutes into an episode and everyone's like, oh, restart.
Yeah, we'll be pretty deep in.
Yeah, and then we're like, why are we restarting, bro? We can just cut it out.
I remember I was like 15 minutes in. I was like, uh-oh. I forgot to restart recording on Audacity. We got to restart one more time.
Yeah, we were so new at podcasts. I'm not going
to
lie.
We still are. I mean, to be fair, there's so many fuck-ups that happened.
Yeah, but you know what? No one asked for the breaker to blow in the house and then to turn off everything and the house almost burned down. And
yeah, that was cool.
All right, let's make a prediction, okay? Because this house has been really cursed with so many issues. What do we think the next... issue is going to be? I think sinkhole. I swear on it. I'm telling you.
Sinkhole?
That water in the empty pool went somewhere and it didn't go in the atmosphere.
You don't know that.
It did not evaporate.
You don't freaking know that.
What do you think?
Prove it.
You're being childish.
Prove it.
You're being childish.
I'm not.
What do you think is going to happen?
I don't know.
Please don't do that with that mic. My balls have been on that mic. So anyway, what do you think is going to happen, Larry?
To the pool or to the house?
To the house.
I think we got our electric shit pretty, you know. We already had the AC, that's air.
Yep.
Electric, that's electricity.
Mm-hmm.
There hasn't been a fire yet. Mm-mm. There hasn't been like something water.
But there has been.
There has been like a water leak. The roof is leaking.
What?
There's like water dripping on the...
Oh, you're talking about outside?
From the attic, yeah.
What?
Yeah.
There's water leaking from the attic?
No, I don't know where he's getting all that.
From the garage.
That's the gutter.
Bro, that's the gutter outside.
Okay. Are you sure?
Bro, he's trying.
Yeah, it's coming from a big hole. It's a drainage hole.
More reaches than Halo, bro. Anyway.
How about we just say the water was the pool? Like, that was way easier.
How about a fire? It hasn't been a fire. It's been close. I think what it is, I think... That last electric burst
was the fire.
No, that was a foreshadow. It's like, yo, we're creeping up to this point.
What, you just want to? Do you just want to die in the house? Just say it.
No, we don't have to die because there's a fire. We can just leave the house.
Well, hold on now. I just saw.
We
on
also
the news.
Have a fire extinguisher.
I just.
Yeah, so we do.
We'll be okay.
One fire extinguisher. Yeah. Are you sure it's not expired? And are you sure it's the right 100%. Fire extinguisher?
Yeah.
Did you know that a fire extinguisher has different uses for it? Like,
really?
If you don't have an electrical fire extinguisher, then it's not going to really do too well for an electrical fire.
Water. Duh.
Wait. So true. I saw a video of a house that blew the fuck up randomly a few days ago, by the way, and everyone died in it.
Whoa, wait, why were you laughing?
Was it? Yeah, why are you laughing?
That was a nervous laugh. That was a nervous laugh, bro. Did you guys see that Donald Trump is now going to be surrounded by
No, we're not. We're not.
So how have you guys been personally?
Dude, is this the therapy gecko?
I'm sorry, but I didn't know sitting there and not talking was a part of the podcast episode.
It is. Watch. You have to enjoy the... Be comfortable in some silence. Watch.
How much longer are we going to sit here?
You're the one who loves the silent moments, and you can't even damn play your own game, damn.
Are we ever going to release the footage of us going to Trump Burger?
What in God's name? We did go to Trump Burger. It is true.
We went with Jay Schlatt.
We did.
We were filming a car video.
We had a great time. I was wearing aviators, and we had burgers.
Which I didn't even know it was like allowed.
What?
You could have a Trump Burger.
You can't. They got shut down.
Did they?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny as hell.
Closed up.
Yeah, I remember I was getting shit because you had what? You ate the Trump Tower and I had the Trump chicken sandwich or some shit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. The Trump onion rings, the Trump French fries, the Trump burger, Trump burrito.
I will give it to them though.
A little ironic.
It was, I don't think they were related. They were just mega fan. That's like mega fucking fan. Making a burger joint, naming it, like, that's like,
could you imagine, like,
so Isaac Y shop, Isaac Y burgers.
There goes my joke, butchered and ruined.
What did I say?
The Big T, Big T bowls, where you go in and you get a bowl full of teriyaki chicken and rice. You have the soft willy.
Mm-hmm. Why not just Big T's and it's just a strip club?
I thought we were going with food. You just,
no, we're just talking about like being a mega fan and like naming something after that person.
I'm such a big fan of Tanner, of Big T, that I'm going to make a strip club.
And everyone, Big T's. And every stripper in there has to look like us.
Every, look like us?
Yep.
Okay.
Every stripper. Has
every single
look
one.
Like us. Mm-hmm. Wears a silicone mask of one of us.
Yeah, it's just like, or it's like a
big, I'm not going to lie, Big T's is definitely some sort of strip club somewhere. It has to be.
I think so.
Imagine seeing Big T. Where are you going this weekend? I hit Big T's. Watch the game. Some NASCAR. Bud Light. Hoorah.
Because it makes sense. Big T's.
Yeah, it does make sense.
I don't think I need to explain it either.
No, you don't.
I think it's self-explanatory. Okay.
So
for,
back
for
to
all the wholesome frogs at home, I think that you God. Can ask your not-so-wholesome family.
Yeah, give them a call. Ring them up. Hey, call that grandma you haven't ringed up in a while and ask, hey, grandma, what's T's?
Hey,
what's,
why didn't you hold him accountable and tell him that it's rang up, not ringed up?
I wasn't even listening. In one ear, out the other.
Did you hear that? He just said he doesn't listen
wow.
to you. You do that a lot.
I was looking at Grunk's cats. I won't lie to you. Right there on the computer.
Hey, I'm sorry that he didn't listen to you, friend.
Can you say it again?
Why didn't you correct me?
Yeah, because why I'm not the type to do that. I'm not the type to correct you. I heard ringed, and then he was the one who corrected me and made me apologize for fucking up. So I thought, well,
no,
why
cursing.
This is an honest apology. I'm sorry. Do you accept?
Why'd you have to clarify?
Because the first one wasn't real. No.
So you admit to lying, and you just had to preface the next apology with a...
If you admit to lying, can you be considered a liar anymore?
Yeah. You admit to doing it.
Wait, that's like saying... It's like,
but you're
the,
honest.
That's like the Pinocchio paradox.
Yeah, like...
My nose is about to grow. Wait, no, how does it go?
What is the Pinocchio paradox?
The Pinocchio paradox is where he says...
My nose is about to grow.
My nose is about to grow, and then it doesn't grow, which is a lie then. So then it should grow, but then he did grow, so then it's a truth.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying?
Dude, what is wrong with your entire computer right now?
You're just hardcore stuck on Windows mode.
Yeah, you are.
He's, when you touch a Mac, you're like... Shit.
Yeah, Mr. Clip Studio, Mr. Vegas Pro.
Dunk on him.
Get on his ass, huh? Poof. Get on his ass.
What's it like
my
using
old
versions?
My nose will grow now. And since he can't magically grow a nose, it wouldn't grow, right? Well, then it wouldn't grow because the statement would be true, and then it wouldn't grow. But by not growing, it's a lie, and it's supposed to grow, and the cycle repeats. Okay, that's...
Wow. Hey, can we solve a riddle?
Why?
Let's just look up a riddle and see if we can solve one. Let's see if we're smart enough.
You're just making me lean.
I suck at riddles. 107 awesome riddles for kids? If I can't even solve a riddle for kids, then I'm fucking dumb.
I looked up riddles for infant.
Riddles for infants?
Yep.
Fucking Google Gaga, dude. I don't know, too.
Well, I did Google it.
Okay, no, riddle. All right, close your eyes. Close your eyes. Close your eyes, Isaac. Close your eyes. Don't read.
What?
How many months of the year have 28? That's not a riddle.
February.
Scroll down.
Yay.
Oh, wait. No, how many months of the year?
All of
no,
them.
It's just all of them.
God
yeah.
damn it.
Dude, you're dumb.
It's not a riddle. It's a damn tongue twister.
Scroll them. Scroll them. Scroll down, and I'll read them for you.
Hey, all right, no, how hey, about this? What has a hand and a... What? What has hands and a face but can't hold anything or smile? A clock.
Yeah, I'm gonna plus rep and vouch on that one. You heard that one. Clock.
What? No.
Yeah, you did.
Hands in the face.
Hey, on mom. Yikes. Wait, belongs to you, but your friends use it more. Your name.
Oh.
Think so?
Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, scroll down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Damn. I didn't even get that one.
Come on now.
Shit. All right, do another one. I actually like.
Kate's mother has three children. Snap, Crackle, and...
It's not Pop.
It's definitely not.
Has three
it's
children?
It's
Kate. Yeah, it is Kate.
Snap,
Kate's mother.
Crackle, and Kate.
Yeah. It's what? Her mother. She's a daughter. It is Kate.
Kate has three children?
No, Kate's mother has three children.
Oh. I was like, what? Okay. Fucking narcissist.
Snap, Crackle.
Snap, Crackle, and Pop! It's Pop!
The idiot in the back.
What do you mean it's not Pop?
What do you mean?
It goes snap, crackle, pop. Not snap, crackle, Kate.
No. Dude, listen. Listen to me.
Listen, I understand you where you're coming from, but it goes snap,
listen,
crackle,
it's going to break
pop.
Your mind.
It's snap, crackle, pop.
Snap, crackle, and pop. What do you not get?
If you don't keep me, I'll break. What am I?
A promise.
Dude. Dude, if you're friggin' right, I'm gonna use code GROOVE for 10% off, dude.
Go ahead.
Promise.
No, dap me up for real.
God, it's make it so hard.
Dude.
Ow, bro. My lats.
I dapped you up. I didn't hit your lat at all.
You're pulling my entire arm out of my socket.
Does it feel good?
No.
Oh, you do not want to play the lateral game.
It's a finger grip strength game.
And it looks like you're losing.
It's because my fingers are about to slip out of your...
All right, folks, we're going to get the 2024 finger grip. Oh,
I'll give it up.
And there's the Olympian winner right here.
Larry needs to answer this next one.
Yeah, okay.
There's only one word in the dictionary that's spelled wrong. What is it?
There's only one word.
I know the answer.
Spelled? Mm-hmm. Isn't it spelled or spelled?
It's wrong.
It's spelled, isn't it? Spelled or spelled?
Okay, there's only one word in the dictionary that's spelled wrong. What is it?
Don't look at me for help, camera.
Don't think about it too deep, bro.
Just think about it high.
He's getting nervous. He's getting sweats.
Man,
I'm looking around the room. I'm okay? Trying to look for answers.
Would you like the answer?
I would like the
answer. I'm going to assume because I don't actually know.
I admit defeat and I would like the answer.
I think that the answer is wrong.
It's wrong.
Oh my God. I knew it was like one of those things where it's
you
like.
You said incorrect.
Yeah, I was like, I don't remember which one it was.
Incorrect.
Is it wrong?
I think it is.
I think it's wrong.
The word is wrong. Yeah.
R-I-N-G. How is it spelled wrong?
That's this thing. It isn't spelled wrong in a literal. It's like a figurative.
There's only one word in the dictionary that's spelled.
Oh my God, I'm
wrong.
Stupid.
Hey, relax. Okay, chill, buddy. Relax.
Buddy, relax.
Have some Propel.
Okay. All right, next one.
Yeah, let's scroll down a little.
Next one.
You're running a race at the very end. You pass the person in second place. What place do you finish the race in?
Isaac knows.
First. Wait, you passed a person in second place. So you're in second place.
Yes. You're in second place.
There you go.
That is correct. Amundo, give it up. Nice, fresh whittle.
There you go.
Oof. All right. I have a tail and a head, but no body. What the hell am I?
Tail and a head, but no body.
Sperm.
It's a pretty...
Why is this for kids? The answer is sperm. That's fucked up.
Think like a kid for a second.
Oh.
Chicken nugget.
I have a tail and a head, but no body. What am I? It's a coin.
Yes, it is a coin. Good. Yeah, that's a good guess. 100% is a coin.
He told me to think like a kid, so I'm like, okay. Larry's like, oh.
Hey, this guy's blown away by a kid's riddle. Get him!
All right.
Look, we've clearly gotten the riddles for kids, but what if we did riddles for adults?
Okay, yeah. Try riddles for elderly. That's like end of the life things. No, you got to know everything
riddles,
about life.
Oh my God.
Riddles for monks and Wise.
You have to be so wise.
Search up riddles for the visually impaired.
Oh, it's on Reddit. You know it's good. 8 years ago, too? Oh, they're vetted.
They're vetted.
It's going to be some live shit.
How many monks left and why?
What the hell? No, dude.
Search up riddles that'll make you lose your mind and go to jail.
Oh.
Search up riddles that you look up on a podcast Jump and then crash to. Out and like break all the equipment.
Search up riddles that make you tear up and cry in front of everyone.
All right. Well, we just spoiled the first one, but we're going to go to the second one.
Okay. Question. Ask this question all day long, but always get completely different answers, and yet all the answers will be correct.
What time
what
is it?
What is the question? But always... Yeah, I think it's... What time is it?
Yep.
So it's...
Yeah. So what time is it?
Wait, wow! You're an adult.
I'm a riddle master. Well,
what if you ask two people in the same time, like in the same minute?
Well, all the answers will be correct.
No, but it's just different.
Oh.
See, you're splitting the hairs and taking the fun out of my riddles.
Wait, dude, this is the riddle
fun on my riddles.
The riddle paradox is happening.
It is.
Yeah, it's already happening. Okay, keep going.
What loses its head in the morning but gets it back at night?
My dick.
A gecko.
Hey.
A gecko.
Hey. Wait,
no,
what?
No, but yeah, I think he's right. A lizard gecko?
Loses its head in the morning but gets it back at night?
Wait, think about it like this. Ahead of time.
I swear to God, if it's another time one, bro. Like, we see clock. We see what time it is. If it has to do with a clock again, I'm going to...
Wait, hold on. I'm thinking.
Okay.
Loses its head in the morning, but gets it back at night. A pillow. I was going to say a pillow.
What loses its head?
Because you get up. Because you get up.
You get up for the day and you go to bed at night.
I actually thought about pillow.
You lay your head back on the pillow.
I don't know. I slept at like... Dude, I slept... I don't know.
Whatever. Yeah, wait. Actually, this one doesn't work for us D-gens. Yeah, no. Us podcasters wouldn't get this
one. Adult riddles suck. They all have paradoxes in them.
Yeah, they all have like real meanings. I don't fuck with these. I like the snap, crackle, cape.
What happened to chicken nuggets?
Oh, no.
That was never an answer.
Keep saying it. I missed the kid level ones. This one looks annoying.
Dude, this is like paragraph, bro.
Four cars come into a four-way stop, each coming from a different direction. They can't decide who got there first, so they all go forward at the same time. All four cars go, but none crash into each other. How is this possible?
Yeah, but the riddle's trying to make you assume that they're coming to an intersection, which they didn't state. So all it's saying is that they went to a four-way stop coming from different directions. So, I mean, they just all went in different directions. I don't know. Maybe that's my answer.
Maybe one turned left.
Four cars come to a four-way stop. No, they each come from a different direction. I think it is a four-way stop, and that's not like a... Gotcha.
Well, they're trying to say that everyone came to a four-way stop intersection, and then, oh no, they all didn't know who went first, so they all went together. And you're supposed to be like, no, you can't, that's going to cause an accident. But that's what they want you to think. It's either it's a fucking roundabout, which doesn't make any sense.
Oh, wait.
Because they're all going the same direction. Oh, wait.
Well, they're all coming
from different directions.
So that actually makes a lot of sense.
Oh, like, and only adults know about roundabouts, not
only
kids.
Adults, not no kid knows about roundabouts.
Yeah.
Let's see what the answer was.
They all made right-hand turns.
Oh, well, we overcomplicated
Which
it.
Is a roundabout.
Technically,
you go in, you go right.
You go in, you have to.
It's a four-way stop.
But you still have to go right.
All right.
Roundabouts technically do have yields.
Yeah, I was about to say that. Yeah, consider that factoid for the day.
But, I mean, okay, well, adult riddles won, the group zero.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Now, we've gotten a lot of these so far. I think adult riddles won, the group like four.
Five. Oh, yeah, four.
Okay, five.
I have a head like a cat and feet like a cat, but I am not a cat. What am I?
A feline. A dog.
Head like a cat. Feet like a cat, but they're not a cat.
Mm-mm. What am I?
Head.
Wow. Head boring ass riddle.
Yeah, what's the fucking answer? God damn it.
A kitten. Go fuck yourself. That's so lame. It's not a riddle. It's
I like the kid ones. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, the
I enjoyed the kid riddles.
Kids are cool.
Hold on.
They're like,
one.
What's red, but also not red at the same time? Red.
Red.
Who makes it has no need of it. Who buys it, has no use for it. Who uses it, can neither see it nor feel it.
Dude, this is like a proverb from the Bible.
Kim Jong-un makes it.
Who makes it?
Kim Jong-un buys it, but has no need for it. And Kim Jong-un uses it, but neither can see or feel it because he's God.
Really?
Oh, it's a kitten. Oh, wait, no, that's the wrong one.
Do you want to lock in Kim Jong-un?
Kim Jong-un.
A coffin.
Who makes it, but has no need for it?
I got a riddle.
Okay.
What can be bought with 10% less the cost? But I don't know.
But you do need it.
But you do need it.
You do need it, and it helps you a lot.
I'll tell you the answer.
Freaking Bud Light. Ah!
Bud Light like my hair I have on.
He's our village idiot.
He's so fun.
Oh, my knee just cracked. I'm old. I belong reading these riddles.
You're the village
day.
Old.
The heck? Do you like the bottom of my shoes? They're running shoes.
Dude, those are... It's like dirty.
Okay, so first of all, they're clean.
No,
and I'm
bro.
Not gonna, and I refuse to show them the tops.
That's bad. That's like you purposely tried to fuck it up.
I wore these shoes when I was doing work on my car, and unfortunately...
Wait, you stick your entire foot in the engine bay?
Well, so I realized yesterday, so I was like on my knees, and I was doing work, and all the ground is all dirty and stuff. So I had so much dirt on my knees, it looked like I was actually wearing knee pads. Because it was just covered in dirt. Shit. So what I did was I would like wash my knees off and then the water would drip down onto all, like the dirty water and stuff. Would drip
I wish
onto
being
my
on
shoes.
The computer would do that to you. Like make it look like you worked hard.
But, yeah.
There's no... There's
well,
no
you, get, you get gamer dent hair.
Okay.
And you get, yeah, you get greasy fucking hair and face.
Okay. It's true.
And body odor. So it kind of does work.
And like unshaved facial hair.
Unshaved
maybe?
Facial hair.
That's true.
Bad body odor.
Bad body odor. Stained clothes.
Stained clothes from eating all the food and being fucking dumb and lame.
Okay, that's true. Yeah. I guess that's like our interpretation of working.
Yeah.
Working hard.
Dude, I'm going to be honest.
Hard work, work.
Streaming and being a YouTuber is like probably just as difficult as being a first responder. I think we can all agree. Okay, that was the riddle. So now,
the answer is a lie.
Can we get that?
Someone's gonna take that out of context and believe that.
That's podcast nowadays, bro. These dudes, I swear, they keep coming up on my For You page talking about some dumbass shit.
Oh my god, here they go again.
The mask one and his damn reactions.
The
I can't
mask
get over.
One. It's not COVID anymore. Why does he have a mask on? He's dancing some dumb shit. His damn podcast. I swear to God, people, who's giving these folks money?
Amen. Amen.
And that was another riddle that was called Fun with the Friends.
Fun with the Friends.
Everything's a riddle in life if you think about it.
How?
There's always meaning. That's right in front of your face. That's what a riddle is. Makes you overthink. That's the whole point. Life is more simple. You just got to think simpler.
Okay.
I'm going to read into you. Can I see your palm? Can I see your palm?
I'm
going to
read my palm?
I've been doing a little bit of palm reading.
Oh, really?
Yeah, come here. Let me see your palm.
Yeah.
Oof. Woo! Oh! Ah!
Do you think hella bad vibes are on my palm, Doc?
No, dude, you are in grave suffering from overthinking. Really? Riddles are not for you.
Oh, man.
Damn. You think over too much.
How do I fix this, Doctor?
Adderall will help you focus. A lot of it.
What kind of Adderall?
Sir? How many milligrams, Doc?
XR and instant release at the same time. 50 milligrams total.
Gosh damn. That with my 400 milligrams of gamer subs I have every morning will blend swimmingly.
Yeah, Doc, how do you wash it down?
You talking about your Adderall?
Yeah.
With 1,000 milligrams of caffeine. Look, what your body needs is a jump start.
Right, we're like an engine.
You need a reminder that you're a living, breathing thing by making you feel like you're about to explode.
So your brain relies off of electricity.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to shock your brain back into order.
Yeah, viewers at home, believe it or not, caffeine can be stored a lot like fat. and there's nothing stopping you from having, you know, your week's worth of caffeine in 2 hours. That's a very, very simple solution for get some lean. The whole thing a day.
Hey, and if you have like the heart tweakies like me, where you feel a little uncomfy with the caffeine, then just drink caffeine. Like I do. I drink flavored water. And hey, listen, if people call you a bitch for that, yeah, you are. But at least you're enjoying something that's fucking awesome.
Yeah, you are.
I am a bitch, and I love flavored water. I don't care.
I like...
You guys remember Mio? Remember Mio?
We just saw Mio, yeah.
I know you used to have Mio at your house.
I did.
I remember that was the first time I saw that shit.
Wait, was that shit we saw at the grocery store?
Yep.
It's where, like, oh, where you go, you flavor your water with
what
it.
What the fuck? That's crazy you brought that up. I randomly pulled it out of one of the shelves, and I was like, what the fuck is, like, who would ever pick this up and ever use this? And then Isaac was like, oh, that. I was like, no way.
Yeah, Isaac's family loved them.
That's crazy.
Yeah, Grant and I come from the background of Mio users.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa.
Where we put Mio in everything, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Everything, bro.
Yep.
So, bread, butter, Mio. Chicken McNugget, Mio. Mio.
They Mac should make, and Mio.
We should start normalizing food flavors for... Wow, that's actually kind of crazy. I just remembered that. Hold on. You know, food flavors in, like, things that should not have food flavors in them?
Are you talking about, like, artificial flavoring?
Yeah. So, like, you know, like, you have pumpkin pie as, like, a flavor. But imagine that in, like, a liquid form. That'd be gross, right?
I think that would piss me off.
Think so?
I think that would. I think that I'd get really, really mad. Hey, while Isaac's looking that up, really quick, if you're still listening to this, the group is going to TwitchCon. We will be there. We're going to have a meetup at the GamerSups booth, I believe at like 11:30. So, with that being said, if you do go to TwitchCon San Diego, we will be there on Saturday. Well, we're going to be there every day. But we're going to have a meetup, and we're going to probably talk about it these next few podcasts, but that's in a month. Go ahead.
Yay. A month, really?
It's in a month. Are we recording last to leave UC?
No.
Early?
Yes, bro, we are. Well, look at this. This is exactly what I was saying when it's like food flavors that shouldn't be in water format. Do you know what's going on here?
It looks like there's hot fudge sundae sparkling water by Liquid Death.
That's correct.
That looks disgusting.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm being for real and honest with you.
It really does.
Is that what actually comes out of it?
No, this is just a commercial.
Oh.
So, but it is sparkling water that is flavored like hot fudge. And I don't know why.
That bothers me a little bit.
Because
it wouldn't have the same viscosity as hot fudge.
Well, yeah, it's just like it's water. Like it's seltzer. The bubbles and everything. You know, when you have seltzer, you're never going to expect like hot fudge, anything, ice cream, something, whatever. So,
right.
I don't even know what the hell, but...
Right. Oof. Yeah.
Van Leeuwen? Who is it?
He's
Van Leeuwen?
Larry. No, he's an artist.
Van Leeuwen. Who is it?
Van Leeuwen is ice cream.
Oh. Well,
there you go.
That's fitting. It is really fitting.
Began as a food truck in New York City in 2008 between Van Leeuwen, his brother Ben, and their partner Laura O'Neill.
Oh, what a stupid name. You had Van Leeuwen, Ben Leeuwen, and
Laura McNeil. Like, yeah,
that's stupid, what I thought. Stupid.
Yeah.
I want Van, Ben, and...
Van Leeuwen, Ben Leeuwen, and Han Leeuwen.
That's literally...
Lorraine Leeuwen.
I hate to do this to you guys, but that's literally a snap, crackle, fucking Kate.
Oh, damn it.
It is. That's true. I wonder if that's how they thought of the riddle. Like a moment like this.
I think so.
Snap, crackle, and Kate.
If you could make up one brand, what would it be?
What?
If you could make your own brand and name it whatever you want it to be, what would you name it?
Why would I? What? That's such an open question.
If you could make your own company, dude, what would you do?
What would I do?
And what would your name be?
I have to think of a really...
Larry?
Regevald.
Regevald?
Yep.
What do you do?
Well, what don't I do? Do it all, Regevald. That's what they say. That's my catchphrase. Do it all, Regevald.
Okay.
We do it all.
I'm going to make a moving company that goes head-to-head with Hunks, who move junk. Mm-hmm. College Hunks. Mm-hmm. Who Moved Junk. And it's going to be called I Got It. And every single time you see, you know, you call I Got It, big, huge guy comes in, mm-hmm. just grabs the couch. Boom. The other hand, boom, picks okay, it up. He's like, wait. And just, everyone's like, "Are you, whoa, whoa, like, that's big. Like, are you okay?" He's like, "I got it. I got it." And he like walks out in the end.
That's good. That's really good.
Mm-hmm. And then, you know, after I clock out of my day job, I go play ball with my super triathlete son, who just manages to throw the perfect spiral football like directly too high. And I'm backing up and I'm like, "Don't worry, son. I got it."
Hmm. You're gonna like OBJ that shit?
Mm-hmm, because I got it.
Are you gonna wear a glove?
No.
I would make Apple, but APPOL, and then I would compete. Assuming that the laws where they would not tell me that I sound too close to Apple would kick in.
That was like a moment where like you said something genius and the two guys laughed at you and then you become a millionaire.
Yeah, you guys are looking at me now.
Yeah, you just reminded me of like an ADHD brain cell.
Well, I feel like Apple,
there he goes,
could do a lot of things. Like we're not just a phone company or a laptop company. We're a lifestyle company. And Apple, you want to be a part of the Apple family, APPOL.
Mm-hmm.
Because we make headphones, we make monitors, we protect your data.
It's just Apple. You're just stealing a brand and misspelling its name.
I'm going to call up Steve. I'm going to have him become the CEO. Steve's
dead.
Steve, 22-year-old Steve that we just called to talk about his cats.
You can't just say that and then... You can't bring up Apple and then say you're going to call Steve.
His name's Steve Wobbs. From Apple.
Is that your try not to laugh face?
No.
Look, you're about to cry.
No, I don't.
You snickered.
Yeah, I smiled because I can see the vision. Because I'm seeing the money roll in, and then I'm going to donate all of it to charity. Because it's actually a charity.
We're reaching dangerous territory. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for tuning in to...
How about you two catfight?
God damn.
How do you do that?
I don't know.
Just like this?
Not a cat... Okay, mental catfight. Verbal catfight.
Mental catfight?
Verbal catfight.
I'm really good at that.
I'll just play with his mind, like gymnastics.
No, you won't.
You couldn't even handle
You're not
my,
capable.
You couldn't even handle my Apple argument.
Apple argument?
Yeah, my Apple conundrum.
It's boring yawn. Don't care.
You're like, oh, let me just... Oh, you already... They already have a Steve. Oh, there's already an Apple. Bro, yep. We're different.
You're still going.
We moved Diffie.
Moved Diffie.
Like, what?
All I hear are you just deflecting. I shoot at you, you go, ping. I shoot you again, ping.
Are you stealing ideas?
No, I'm not. Clap back.
Like, you stole an idea.
Clap back.
I want to hear it. And you want to call Steve Wobbs?
Look at me and clap back.
You want to steal? You want to steal?
Deflection.
You want to steal? I'm with you the whole...
Deflection.
I'm with you the whole...
Deflection.
You're not catching the football.
Deflection. If you face revealed, you'd look like Peyton Manning.
If you covered your face, everyone would think you look like Bob the Tomato.
I think that I look more like, you know, the Costco guys. Boom! Boom! Mm-hmm. Boom!
Yeah.
Boom!
All you can think about is Costco and
boom!
Dude.
Huh?
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Like, you sit there and you badger and badger and badger, like, over and over again. And I have to sit here and just, like, we were supposed to end like 2 hours ago. Why are we still here? Why are you still talking?
Well, honestly, I don't really...
Honestly, I think I'm going to name my company Apple, and I'll have Steve Wobbs.
We already addressed that. I already talked to you about that.
What are you, a salad, bro?
Okay, let's end the podcast. All right. Bye, ladies and gentlemen. What do we say, folks? What do we say?
We're still going, dude.
Invest into my company, Apple, if you guys want to...
Thank y'all for tuning into the Group Chat Podcast episode. Bicker, argue, and be angry.
Oh, what is this? My big old belly.
That's Belly. I'm Smelly. Say goodbye to...
And that's just Larry. Wait, Larry. No. Yeah, that's just Larry.
Make sure you use code GROUP for 10% off your gamer subs, and we'll see you next time where there will be more than just three of us, and especially two on camera. Goodbye.
Let us know if you like these types of podcasts, because I feel like this is pretty fun.
Foodbye and Garewell. Goodbye. Oh. Where are you going?